Hello everyone, welcome to another video of this revision series. In this video, we will talk about pain inhibiting mechanisms of our body. And the first theory is gait control theory. According to this theory, the large diameter afferents carrying touch fibers and the small diameter afferents, that is S fiber or A delta and C fibers, A delta for the fast pain and C for the slow pain, carry pain sensation, both act upon an inhibitory neuron of substantia gelatinosa called SG neuron. Also, both of them stimulate T cell, which is the pain afferent transmitted centrally from the dorsal horn. Now, activity in the large diameter afferents stimulate the SG neuron, which in turn inhibits the stimulation of T cell by both L and S fibers. This explains inhibition of pain when large diameter afferents carrying touch sensation are stimulated. In this case, the gate is closed. On the other hand, activity in the small diameter afferents inhibits SG neuron. So, the inhibiting effect of SG neuron is now removed, the gate is now open, and thereby activity in the small diameter pain fiber is transmitted centrally through the T cell as pain sensation. Next is endogenous pain inhibiting mechanisms, and this gait control theory is somewhat applied for acupuncture for pain inhibiting mechanisms. Where locally touching sensation may result into pain inhibiting mechanism. Next is the endogenous pain inhibiting mechanisms. Here, opioid peptides play a major role, and opioid peptides are mainly three types: endogenous opioids, that is encephalin, endorphin or dynorphin, and these opioid peptides act on the various G protein coupled receptors called mu, kappa or delta receptors, which ultimately causes reduction of cyclic AMP and thereby hyperpolarization and thereby analgesia or inhibition of the pain stimulus. The endogenous opioid peptides play at specific receptors present on the periaqueductal gray in midbrain. From the PAG region, there emerges some encephalinergic neurons to reach the raphe-magnus nucleus in the medulla. And from this raphe-magnus nucleus, some serotoninergic neurons arises after stimulation, and they ultimately converge with encephalinergic interneurons, which ultimately end on the opioid receptors present near the pain afferents. And thereby, the release of opioid peptides like encephalin, endorphin or dynorphin, which inhibits the secretion of substance P. And thereby, pain transmission is obstructed, which would occur via lateral spinothalamic tract. So, the opioid peptides here inhibits the neurotransmitter responsible for the pain transmission. Thereby, it will cause analgesic effect. So, this is all about pain inhibiting mechanisms of our body. First is the gait control theory, another is the endogenous pain inhibiting mechanisms by opioid peptides. So, thank you guys for watching.